My name is Dame Mary Peters, and I was a pentathlete and a shot putter. I competed at 3 Olympics and enjoyed every one of them. Pentathlon is 5 events that ladies did to kind of be equal with the decathlon, but it wasn't a real true all-round performance because it embraced the hurdles, the high jump, long jump, shot put and 200 metres. So there was no stamina event and only one throwing event. So after my Olympics, when I broke a world record, and I still hold that record, they changed it. And so instead of running the 200 metres, they ran the 800 metres. But again, that didn't really embrace the whole of the muscles of the body. So they made it a heptathlon, and they brought the 200 metres back and put the javelin in. And I'm so glad I didn't have to do those two events. When I used to high jump, it was a very unorthodox style. It was supposed to be a Western roll, but it wasn't very good. But it was sand, wet sand. So I used to build a pyramid so that I had something reasonably soft to land on. And of course, the Fosbury flop changed all that because she went backwards into a very deep foam bed. And I enjoyed that much better. Although when it was wet, it was almost going through your whole body as you landed on the wet bed, and it would gush up around you. The hurdles are similar. Shot put, oh, they're all always so cold, especially in this climate. I used to bring a bucket of boiling water with me, or a kettle, and fill the bucket and put the shot in so that it wasn't so cold against your chin, which I hated. And the long jump, the sand was always wet. And of course, the 200 meters was my marathon because I wasn't a very good sprinter, but tried hard. Well, I was an unusual pentathlete in that I was a strong athlete because I did a lot of weight training, and of course shot put was one of my strongest events. Most of the athletes are sprinters and jumpers, so doing the 800 metres must be torture for them. I'm glad I never had to do it. But it's the state of mind, and help having your coach develop your weaknesses as well as your strengths. The athletes of today have to do a lot more of psychological build-up for their competition, and they would listen to tapes and they would have favourite pieces of music. We weren't allowed to carry any electrical equipment onto the track because it meant that you could have communicated with your coach, which was not in the rules. So I just used to get a very tight squeeze on my arm from my coach and say, go and do your best. And if I did well, he'd say, that was good, but you could have done better. So coaches really are never satisfied, but it's because they're ambitious for you and they want you to succeed. It's a whole new scene now. I had to concentrate on the 5 events. Nowadays, the girls concentrate on 7. Eventually, I think in years to come, it will become a decathlon. But at the moment, it's hard enough doing 7 events. In my day, we just did it as a hobby. So you did your day's work, or you went out training in the morning before you did your day's work. So it was very different. Nowadays, the athletes can get sponsorship and lottery funding, and they can train all day if they wish. I'm glad it was the way it was for me because it was a hobby and I enjoyed it very much. But if I was doing it full time, I think it might have become more of a chore. The athletes now have to train really, really hard, especially if they're going for Olympic Games, because the standards all over the world have risen so to such a height. But it's still good fun. If you want to do it, you should enjoy it. And that's what I would say to all these young people here. Enjoy every minute of it and train hard and listen to your coach and advisors. After Denise won in Sydney, one of the national newspapers did each of our events, excluding the two that I didn't do. And I would have beaten Denise, even though it was all those years on, because I had strength and speed. But now, of course, Jessica is way superior to that, and I wouldn't have come near her. I'm very full of admiration for Jessica and her wonderful performance at the Olympics, not only because of the skills and she's such an attractive athlete, but she also was able to rise to the pressure of being on home territory. And the crowd were very supportive, of course, but that's added pressure when you're competing. There are people in British sport who are training very hard for the multi-events, and you know those who will follow in Jessica Ennis Hill's footsteps because they've been inspired by her achievements. But you know, poor Jessica had so many injuries before she retired and had so many disappointments, and that's one of the problems of doing so many events. Every muscle in the body comes into play, and it is severe on the body. But you know, if you train properly and you do plenty of weight training and plenty of stretching and have the right nutrition and give your body lots of sleep and rest, it can do all these events. If men can do 10, women can certainly do 7.